Hello everyone, and welcome to the Sacred Jaguar Hall here at the Mystical Yoga Farm on the beautiful Lake Atitlan. It's a pleasure to hold you in this space today amidst all this chaos and turmoil in the world. Here at the Mystical Yoga Farm, we're sending out our hearts and our love and with intention to provide some peace and tranquility this morning with this practice. This is an offering from the heart. Offering of peace and an offering of love. So again, thank you for being with us. First, we'll clear any obstacles that are in our way. Any thoughts? The best way I know how to do that is to chant to Ganesha. Bear with me, this is my first time sharing a song on the ukulele. Pushing the edges today.
Namaha. Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
Let's all take a deep inhale together. Inside out. Two more just like that. Deep inhale. Today is going to be a yin style yoga practice. We're going to spend a little bit more time in some poses, get into some of the fascia, take our time, restore, rejuvenate. So let's get right to it. First, let's find a comfortable seat. Whatever that means to you. Roll your shoulders up, back, and down. Relaxing the face, lengthening the spine, dropping the chin slightly. Let's begin to tune into our breath. Deep inhales in the ribs, in the chest. And exhaling slowly the chest, the ribs, and then the belly. And now we can bring our hands to heart center. As you unify our practice today, we can inhale to home. Simply just to be present, be still. Sky, and if a rope extended down from the heavens, we begin to climb that rope, reaching as high as you can, grounding both hips into the earth, keeping our shoulders and our face relaxed. Inhale, we can reach both hands high in the sky. And on the exhale, we can drop our right hand down. Come in for a side bend. Keeping our left hip rooted to the earth. We're spiraling our chest open to the sky and breathing deeply here. Deep inhale. Two more breaths here. your next inhale, rise you up high to the sky. Now on the exhale, the left arm comes down, the right hand comes over. Again, we're keeping our right hip glued to the earth, spiraling our heart open to the sky, breathing deep into the belly. Two more breaths here. Inhale, I'll rise you up. And on the exhale, we can bring our left hand behind us, acting as a secondary spine, right hand to right knee, coming into a twist. Deep inhale here. Lengthen. Exhale, twist. Lengthen, exhale, twist. The next inhale, we're going to bring our chin down to our chest. And on the exhale, we're going to roll our right ear over to our right shoulder, getting a nice neck opener here, our twist. Enjoying three more breaths here. And next inhale, let your chin come back to your chest. So on the exhale, we can reach our hands to the sky. Take a deep inhale here. On the exhale, the right hand comes behind the spine, left hand to the right knee, a twist. Inhale and lengthen, exhale and twist. The next inhale, you can bring your chin down to your chest. And on the exhale, you can roll your left ear over to your left shoulder for a neck opener. We can try to relax our shoulders, relax our face. Two more breaths here. Next inhale, bring your chin to your chest. Exhale here. Inhale, reach your hands up to the sky once more. And on the exhale, our hands are going to come forward down into a forward bend. Inhale, we can extend our chest forward, and exhale, we can fully surrender down to the earth. Letting Pachamama hold us today. It's a great time to give gratitude. Come into contact with what you're grateful for today. Thank you. hips towards the back of the room, tails pulling back. We surrender to the earth. We're going to begin a cat-cow practice. On the inhale, we're going to drop the belly, take the position up, and on the exhale, we're going to round the spine, tuck the tailbone. Inhale, drop the belly, lift the gaze. Exhale, round the spine, tuck the tailbone. Once you've gone through this few times, some intuitive movement, if you'd like to bring that into the practice. Making some hip circles in both directions. Maybe coming into some lateral circles. Whatever feels good for your body in this moment. Working out the kinks in the spine. Balance here, toes come together, knees come wide, drop down into a child's pose. Sinking the hips back, bringing the chest to the earth. Fully surrendering here, coming back to the intention that we made earlier in the practice. Thank you. here in child's pose, fully releasing. Mm-hmm. From child's pose, we're going to slowly transition into a puppy pose. Puppy pose is in between a child and a downward facing dog. So from child's pose, we extend our hands, edges of our mats, our feet are parallel, our knees are underneath our shoulders, and then we drop our chest to the earth, our hips pull up and back as we surrender our heart to the earth. Breaths here in our puppy pose, really letting your heart kiss the earth. We're gonna transition out of puppy pose into tabletop. In tabletop, our hands are underneath our shoulders, our knees are underneath our hips. On the inhale, we're going to rise our right hand up to the sky. And on the exhale, we're going to thread the needle through. Coming down for a shoulder stretch. Right ear comes down to the earth. With our left hand, we can either stretch it out in front of us, or if you'd like, and wrap it around to your back hip. Two more breaths here. Mm. next inhale, brings you up. Bring the hand all the way up to the sky. Exhale, bring it back down to the earth. On the other side now, raising the left hand up to the sky, opening up the heart. And on the exhale, we're threading the needle through. That right hand, you get the option to walk it out in front of you, wrap it around to your back hip. To a lizard pose, getting a nice inner hip opener. We're going to bring our right foot to the outside of our front right hand. We can first come up onto our toes on our back foot, just to stretch and some nice distance there. And you can then drop that back knee. And take a deep inhale and rise to heart. And on the exhale, we can slowly come down to the forearms or whatever feels comfortable for you. You can come all the way down. You have the option here to open up that foot like a book if you'd like. Deeper stretch in the inner hip. Also, you can do a wandering lizard, walking your hands out towards the left, and then coming down to the forearms. Breathing deeply here into that hip. Two more breaths here on the side. Next inhale.
transition through tabletop. Now bringing that left foot forward on the outside edge of the left hand. Again, you're coming up on the toes, lengthening, creating space. And then you drop that back knee. Take a deep inhale and raise the heart. And on the exhale, you can again come down to the forearms. As low as feels comfortable for you. Options here again, to open up that foot like a book. Maybe put a little pressure inside of the thigh. Or the wandering lizard, walking our hands out toward the right corner. Taking time in all the spaces on the inner hip, exploring. So I'll take a deep inhale together and sigh out. Two more long deep breaths here in our lizard pose. You up back into tabletop. We're going to transition into a pigeon pose. So bringing our right knee to our right wrist, our right ankle to our left wrist, figure four. Again, you can come up onto the toes to create some space. Dropping that back knee down. We want to keep our foot flexed to protect our knee. Take a deep inhale and rise up. Bring our chest to the sun. And on the exhale, you can slowly begin to come down into a reclined pigeon pose. Whether that's the forearm, or maybe you can bring the chest and the forehead to the earth. I'm going to pull our right hip back towards the back of the room. Keeping it grounded as much as possible. Also fully releasing into the earth. Thank you.
rest here on the side in pigeon pose. Next inhale, you can begin to walk your hands up. Bring that right knee to the earth, into a tabletop, and then reach it straight back, bring the toes to the earth, and you can push out with that right heel and get a nice counter stretch for that hip. And then maybe you want to come up into like a downward dog on that one side, just for a moment. While we're here, you can maybe open up that left hip, keeping our shoulders square, reaching the knee high in the sky, taking a peek at the foot underneath your armpit. So one more deep inhale here, and on the exhale, you can square the hips, bring both knees to the earth. You can then prepare for pigeon pose on the left hand side, bringing the left knee to the left wrist, the right left ankle to the right wrist, so figure four. Again, coming up on the toes on that back foot to create some space. Dropping the knee down, taking a deep inhale, raising the chest, and on the exhale, you can slowly make your way down. Trying to keep that left hip in contact with the earth. Keeping the hips square, fully releasing. Transitioning out of pigeon pose, coming into tabletop, then coming to one side, and we're going to come down to our backs. Those in the room today, you have a strap. It isn't absolutely necessary that you need it. If you don't have one here at home, Facebook world. From the back, fully relaxing into the earth. We'll take our strap, we'll wrap it around.
ball of the foot. We can take it in our right hand. Extend it straight up into the sky, pushing out through the heel. Without the strap, you can do the same thing. Just push out through the heel. Lift as high as you can and relax the rest of the body. Side of our body, bring it down as low as comfortable for you. You want to make sure that we're grounding our left hip into the earth and keeping those hips square as much as possible. Switch from our right hand holding the strap to the left, crossing the foot over the body, keeping our back, shoulder blades on the earth, reaching our right foot as far to the left as possible, pushing out through our heel. Thank you. deep breath here. And the following inhale, you can rise it up to the sky and release the strap. Release the leg down. If you want to shake out that right leg. Maybe you want to roll out the hips. Switching legs to the left from the ball of the foot. Again, if you don't have a strap, it's fine. Pulling the left foot towards the front of the room. Back of the room. Pushing out through our heel. Enjoying that stretch on the back of the leg. Deep inhale here, and on the exhale we can drop our leg to our left side, keeping our right hip glued to the earth as much as possible. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, rise that left foot up to the sky. And on the exhale, we can cross it over our body, bring it down to the floor on the opposite side. Keeping our shoulder blades glued to the earth. Pushing out through that heel. Two more breaths here. Next inhale, lift the leg and remove the strap. Come now onto our backs. You can bring the soles of the feet to the earth. Maybe do some windshield wipers with the knees. Savasana, just for a moment here. Maybe you flap your butterfly wings, lift up the inner legs. Relax here just for a moment. Taking deep breaths here. Next inhale, you can bring your knees back up to the sky. Soles of the feet are on the earth. You can walk them back towards your hands. You should have a block nearby if you're in the room. See if you can touch the backs of your heels with your fingertips. On the inhale, you can raise the hips, coming into a bridge pose. Stay here and unsupported. You might want to clasp the hands. Raise the hips. If you have a block nearby, you come into a supported bridge by placing it underneath the sacrum. Think of it as like the top of the bottom. Fully letting go, releasing. Here, just a moment, winding down our practice today. Enjoying three more breaths here in this bridge. Here, raise the hips high. And on the exhale, you can remove the block, come down. Maybe you want to do some windshield wipers again. You can roll the spine out, bring the knees to the chest. Bring the soles of the feet down to the earth. We scoot our hips over to the left side of the mat. We can cross our left leg over our right, coming into cow face legs, lifting our knees. And on the exhale, we can bring that setup over to the right side of our mat for our supine twist. Remembering to keep our shoulder blades glued to the earth. Our gaze will be over our left hand. Taking in the silence around you, taking in the birds, the sounds. Enjoying the silence. I'll take a deep inhale together and sigh it all out. Enjoy two more breaths here on the side. The following inhale, you can lift those knees up, the shins are parallel to the earth, and then unraveling the legs, bringing our soles of our feet to the earth, shaking it out any way that you need. And then scoot our hips to the right side of our mat, cross our right leg over our left, rise them up, shins parallel to the earth, and drop them over to the left side of our mat.
arms like a T, keeping our shoulder blades glued to the earth. With our gaze over our opposite hand. Noticing where our breath is. Take a deep inhale together and let it all go. Enjoy last two breaths here. Make them good, because from this pose we'll transition into our final pose of the day, corpse pose, savasana. Into your shavasana, bring the feet, corners of the mat, relaxing the toes to the outside, fully letting the earth hold the feet as we get into the juiciness of today's offering. So I'll take a deep inhale together. Fully let go. One more deep breath together. And let it go. I invite those who are at home watching to get comfortable, get your blanket, pillow, eye cover as we move into the sound healing portion of today's offering. Take your time to get as comfortable as possible. Perhaps headphones. Fully surrender, be open to the vibrations that come through. Ankles and knees and calves relaxing, and these ankles, feet, calves, shins fully relaxed. Quads and our hamstrings are relaxing. Our legs, our hips are fully releasing to the earth. The fronts and backs and sides of our hips completely relax. Our tummy, our chest is relaxing. Our tummy and chest are completely, completely relaxed. Our shoulders, biceps and triceps, forearms, wrists and hands are relaxing. Our arms and our hands are completely relaxed. Our lower back, our middle back, our upper back, our whole spine is relaxing. Our spine, our back, shoulders are completely relaxed. Neck, the back of the head, the face, the ears, they're all relaxing. Our head and neck, face are completely relaxed. My entire body is completely, utterly relaxed. I'm open to receive. I'm open to heal. I am open. slowly coming back to our bodies. Taking a deep, deep inhale to the belly. Appreciate your presence. We're over here in paradise in our quarantine. We are aware of the civil unrest and chaos and the turmoil and everything going on in the States and in Europe and anywhere else in the world. We feel very blessed here to be on this land, nurturing ourselves, nurturing each other, nurturing the environment around us. And we do send love and send our hearts to all those suffering and all those who are having a hard time in these times right now. So again, extending my greatest gratitude to the spirits of this land, to all our angels and spirit guides and helpers that are with us today. Thank you to the elementals. Thank you to the directions. Thank you for this space. Thank you, Lake Atitlan. Thank you to Grandfather Rock and Grandmother Tree, the guardians here on this land. Thank you to myself for showing up and being here and sharing this from my heart. In Lakesh Alakin.